How's it going?
Welcome to the Drawn Out Podcast.
Hi.
Where Brandon does some stuff and everybody else just sits here.
Yeah, it's true. And today we have a very adequate guest.
Adequate. First, how about we list the people that are here, like Raimi.
And Brandon.
And Brandon.
Two Brandons.
I'm also Brandon.
Three Brandons. Raimi and three Brandons. I'm the one that sticks out. Remember
this
the name.
This is Raimi and the Brandons. We're a new band. It's going to be pretty fucking sick. So that's Tony and Tannen.
Yeah, I'm Tony.
This is Boney.
Boney.
That's a
Boney and Bannon.
Boney and Bannon.
Yeah, and Lannon.
Lannon.
I'm the adequate guest.
Yes. Yeah, we all took a minute out of our busy schedules, drove on down to the movie theater.
Just so we could talk to you fucks.
Yeah, and we're in the movie theater right
we're
now.
In the movie theater. The movie's playing.
They're really mad that we're talking.
Hey. They're being really quiet, though.
No, fuck you, Steve!
Steve, quit being a cunt.
Ow.
As you heard in the recording, Steve didn't say a thing. We're being mean to Steve. Unprovoked.
Steve's a little bitch!
Yeah, Steve.
So.
Get out of here.
Steve's dead now.
I smacked him.
It escalated very quickly.
By us.
Steve still did nothing. Not one thing.
Steve is a gentle
soul.
Steve's
just trying to enjoy a movie with his children. Not anymore.
And they're dead too.
Anyway, so
that
we
was
went,
before though.
So we went and saw Rogue One.
Oh yeah, that's the movie.
That's
yeah.
What this thing's about.
Yeah, it's true.
We saw Rogue One.
You already know that.
We saw Rogue One.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, I did. I also did.
Yeah. What was the title, Tony?
Rogue Two.
Roger Dodger.
Roger Dodger. That's one.
Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. Okay, sure. So going in, I felt like Rogue One had a lot of expectations that everybody was really kind of like, really, really hyped for. That, you know,
that's
it's
great.
One of those movies that had a bunch of shit to live up to.
It's the first Star Wars non-episode live action thing.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah.
Yep, and it was also the very first prequel to the original
and
trilogy
the
that didn't suck.
That's objective.
No, that's completely factual.
Episode 2 is my favorite.
He's
clearly the best
that's
one.
That's when he's at his hottest.
Yeah. Okay.
Fuck sand, right?
Yeah,
so,
fuck sand. Everyone feels the same about sand.
So Boney's dead.
I agree, though. It had a bunch of expectations to live up to, and it did.
Yes.
100%.
Before spoilers, now, if anyone... We'll talk about spoilers later.
Just
but
how we initially felt.
Just a sentence. Yeah, what'd you think of it?
Arguably my favorite.
It made me feel good on the inside, to feel so bad on the inside.
My PP is hard.
I also wanted to say that, but I thought it wasn't going to be funny.
I didn't want it to be cut out, you know, of this sweet PP
sometimes
joke.
You just got to go for it, man.
Yes, I thought it was the closest to the originals any other Star Wars has been.
It's great. It was very good.
Okay, spoilers. Here we are.
Everyone dies.
Spoiler tell.
Everyone dies.
Tannen was glad to tell us that everyone died
before
the movie.
It happened,
it's
yes.
Obvious.
Yeah,
right?
It was painfully obvious. You
they
didn't know.
They describe it as a literal suicide run.
Well,
yes.
Not just that, but I mean, in A New Hope, they kept saying it over and over. They're like, a lot of rebels died to get this. Probably all of them. Like, they said they lost an entire fleet. Like, out of
not just
Tannen,
one.
You said that they have three entire fleets in the Rebel Alliance?
They had three. Now they have two.
Now they have two. And they're a bunch of gays. And we're cool with that.
Hey, it's fine, dude. You want to do whatever
in space,
you do.
No one can hear you scream.
No one can hear you.
No one
fucked.
Can hear you bone.
I didn't think it was painfully obvious until the end. Like, I really thought
you mean,
they...
after
I was,
they died?
No, until the Death Star showed up and I was like, all right, now they're not leaving. But, like, up until then, I thought maybe Jin was going to make it out, like, somehow.
No.
Well, and then two of them died, and then three of them died, and I was like, all right, yep, it's a suicide mission. They're
okay,
all dead.
So...
And then the Death Star showed up, and
oh,
I
yeah.
was reaffirmed
screw
in my
you,
knowledge.
Death Star!
So, let me ask a question.
Uh-huh.
Best death. K2.
In
K2, without a doubt, yeah.
I was going to ask, in the movie, or like, in
the whole
general?
Time.
Hitler. Oh.
Jesus.
I did like the way Jesus died. That was pretty metal.
Tragic tale.
My God has a hammer. Your God got nailed to a piece of wood. What does that tell you?
Aw.
Yeah, K2 was the first death, too.
Yeah.
And he went down like a fucking hard ass.
Yeah, he did.
Everybody
well, he's
else
a robot,
was...
so...
Well, everybody else kind of...
He literally
like...
had a hard ass.
Well, I mean, like, it just, I was really expecting everybody to have, like, this really badass way to die that was, like, you know...
heroic and...
Yeah, well, like, not just heroic, but individualized to them. Like, you know, you were expecting with Donnie Yen fucking being kung fu genius, he was gonna fucking just take out as many as he could and get fucked over. Mm-hmm. And then with the...
instead, he just get fucked over.
Well, I did love the way that he got there beforehand. He was just sitting there, like, holding his stick, walking through this crazy-ass field of lasers, just like, I am one with the Force, the Force is with me, I am one with the Force is with me, fuck, fuck, fuck! And he made it.
He was Stick from Daredevil.
He was.
That's all he was.
Well, yeah.
I think his death was my favorite.
Oh, really?
Like, his was the one that got to me, because it then, like, his friend came out, and he was saying, I'm one with the Force is with me, as he died.
He said it backwards, though.
And then his friend said it backwards like an idiot.
He's like, you said it backwards.
Bunga, bunga. But then that guy kind of, I was expecting, like, a crazy hard-ass death for him. I thought he would go down like a meal from fucking Halo.
Like a meal at my house.
Are you ready? Because I am. Then he gets fucking
shanked. He did go down like a meal at your house. Yeah. Quickly.
Destroyed.
I will say, Emil is one of my favorite deaths in that entire game.
He was the best death.
Next to cats.
Anyway.
Yeah, anyway.
We'll talk about that some other time.
We're Helmet Kids. Always.
Favorite character?
I can't remember the name, but Donnie Yen.
Donnie, probably.
He was
Chirrut.
Chirrut, thank you. Yeah, he was my favorite because
Chirrut.
Chirrut. Yeah. But not just because I'm a huge kung fu fanboy, but because I really like his character being a force sensitive, but like super into it. Like, he was a disciple of the Force, and he just never got to be a Jedi. That was like really. It was. It's kind of fucked up in a lot of ways, but in another way, it was just like, you know, good for you, man, that you still believe in this archaic religion that nobody thinks exists.
It's not archaic!
I mean, I'm pretty sure Han Solo never heard of it.
He didn't.
But see, here's the thing.
And he knows some things.
What I don't get, it's like, and it's one of the biggest things I have with Star Wars, unfortunately, is like, yeah, the Jedi's all died in 1 through 3, right?
Okay.
That's in Kenobi's lifetime. In Anakin's lifetime. Mind you, Anakin's a robot at this point.
Right, Anakin's a robot, and Jedi's live forever.
Yeah, how long do Jedi's live?
And, well, but Yoda was 900 years old before he died.
That's just his, I think that's just how his...
race is.
Yeah. How old was Luke?
That's a good question. Because,
yeah, there's your thing. Because Luke was born at the beginning of... Oh, the end of 3, right?
Yes.
Right.
So,
hey,
you know,
Leia was born too, asshole.
Yeah, you're right, sorry.
Women can do things
now. Misogynist.
Yeah, that's true. Anyways.
Yeah, you got me.
Padme had a litter.
Padme or Panda Bear, whatever her fucking name was.
Had a new kitchen helper.
Died without her man.
Anyways.
So she set the gender back a little bit.
Yeah. But anyways, so, you know, the Jedis were around right before Luke was born.
Right.
Yes.
And then Luke became this, like, assuming, because the description says farm boy, so I'm assuming, like, 20s, like, our age, maybe?
Yeah.
And, like, all of a sudden, it's like, oh, no one's ever heard of a Jedi. Oh, that's kind of weird, right?
Yeah, what's a Jedi?
I guess it also depends on what side of the galaxy you're on, because, like, in certain spots, the Jedi were even, like, barely heard of everywhere else, or, like, even if they did know them, they didn't ever come across them. Jedi are pretty, you know, few and far between.
Right. But still, I mean, like,
I agree,
go far-fetched and saying it's an archaic thing.
No, I agree. And honestly, that was one of the big reasons why the original 3 prequels fucked me over. Like, they took everything that Star Wars was and just pissed all over it. Like, the Force was this whole, it was this mystical, crazy religion energy that you just had to believe in or be really exposed to actually understand or, like, even know existed.
Mm-hmm.
But then the prequels come along and it's like, oh, you're a midichlorian, your cholesterol's really high, man. You're a great Jedi.
You have to pay this amount of money to be this amount of Jedi.
To be this amount
this
of Jedi.
This guy's the chosen one. He's the richest kid in all the land.
But yeah, so the prequels annoy me, except for this one. This is a good one.
Yeah, this is great. I thoroughly enjoyed it.
I would say that it's probably, like Tony said, I think it's probably, it's objectively one of my favorites, if not my favorite. It's on the top 2 list.
Oh yeah, I can definitely see that for a lot of people. Yeah. I just imagine people having their nostalgia glasses. They're just sitting there and they're just like, I don't know, like, it can't be better than these movies, right?
I will say
it's 100% more entertaining than all of the movies combined.
Yeah, that's true. A lot more happens.
Yeah, exactly. You get a lot there of story a lot of in a shorter... Scenes. Well, yeah, the beginning was the really slow. I was falling hours. Asleep for
oh,
a little bit.
God.
I slept throughout the entire movie.
Can you guys tell me
what went on?
I saw it the second time, and, like, I was so tired.
I was, like, I was in and out, half asleep the entire, like, that entirety of the half hour. And then once it got in there, then it was, like... I think it was right when they got to the desert planet.
Jedha.
That was when shit.
Yeah, once they got the Jedha, it was good.
That was when you were fully awake. Nothing had, like, you just, like, you weren't tired anymore. You're just like, fuck yeah, this is great.
Yeah, because everything leading up to Jedha kind of blurred together, but everything after Jedha, I remember
very
clearly.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can I just say fucking Death Star? So I leaned to Brandon at one point after they blow up Jedha. Spoiler alert, they blow up Jedha. I was like, now what part of that doesn't scream, hey, join now? I want to do that.
Welcome to the Nazi party.
I'm so glad we got another Star Wars movie where we got to see the Death Star again.
It was so good.
See, my question...
And it didn't blow up. That's the best part. It doesn't blow up.
My question is, why do they need a fully functional... Death Star, when it's not fully functional, it still fucking destroys planets.
To establish peace throughout
like,
the galaxy.
It does the one thing it's supposed to do,
well,
even when it's not working.
Here's the thing, they never test a full fire until they capture Leia.
And test it on Alderaan, but they still life wiped a fucking planet twice.
Yeah.
Well, see, here's the thing.
Yes.
Would you like your very first dry run of this planet killer? Would you want to be on that spaceship or that freaking?
I wouldn't want to be anywhere near anything. I would like to be.
What if it goes wrong?
I would like a camera that was like 3 billion miles away with like a zoom on that thing, and then I'm safe at home in another galaxy.
That would be really embarrassing if you showed up to Alderaan and just blue-balled everybody on the planet. Just couldn't get it up to kill them.
Sorry, guys, we tried.
Sorry, we're just going to have to wipe you out the old-fashioned way. Sorry. Glass the planet.
Did the, like, the half-power or whatever shot, did it...
Single...
Did it destroy everything on the surface, or was it just that one small area?
It might have been the whole city.
Yeah, it was the whole city, but, like, how far off did it go?
It showed it was a pretty big fucking...
Yeah, it was
a pretty
big
blast radius, but they didn't show it whether it was ended at that point or not, but it was... It looked like it was still continuing.
It was still going.
Yeah.
I definitely
took out Forrest Whitaker.
I love the
pan-up. Forrest Whitaker's death was great, because he looked at that shit, and he's just like... Like, he's like, no, I'm not gonna run anymore. And it's like, you're looking like you're gonna try to fight an explosion. You can't do it. It can't be done.
He probably held his own for quite a while.
He was probably like, man.
Tried.
It's not, I'm not gonna hobble to the ship. I can't get there.
Well, yeah, but
he could have 100% got there.
He could have. Everybody else made it.
He could have.
Not everyone.
Well, yeah, not everybody, but everybody that mattered
made
it.
Sucks to be the guy who didn't have a spaceship that day. The guy who carpooled with his buddy.
Oh,
yeah.
Who else liked those two fuckers?
I want to know how they got off that
from A New
planet.
Hope.
Yeah,
the two guys.
The Jedha?
They were on
Jedha.
Oh
yeah,
and they're I don't like you. That guy.
I have the. What does he say? He has the death sentence on 12 systems.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
and
it.
Yet Jedha and Tatooine, he does not.
Not anymore.
Not anymore, because Jedha's gone.
And so is his arm.
I've heard Forrest Whitaker's character also was in Star Wars Rebels and one of the other animated shows.
Perhaps. I never really watched it.
I never saw the animated shows.
But like a younger version of the same character.
Huh.
Before he was all mechanical.
Before he was part robot.
Before he was a robot.
Is he still as radical as they made him out to be in the movie?
Radical.
I have
robots.
No clue.
He's probably slightly less because it's on a Disney Channel.
See,
that's probably true.
Yeah,
Disney's been Disney's been getting like really ballsy lately. Like they had Gravity Falls, and that's the best thing that I've ever seen in my life. So
ballsy lately?
Yeah, lately.
Like how
in the past like 10 years?
Like
Donald
10
Duck wasn't a Nazi.
Okay, I'll give you that. They've been pretty ballsy.
Mickey
they went
Mouse
through a phase
cheese.
Where they were. They started out really ballsy, and then they went through a phase where they were like, "Let's mellow it down a little bit." Mickey
That's
doesn't
kind of
need
be
to,
nice, maybe.
Mickey doesn't
hey,
need to.
Hey, we're
fuck
doing
Swiss
this for
cheese.
Kids, right?
Are Nazis for kids, John?
John says no.
John says no. We need to listen.
No.
No.
What's
John?
Wrong with you? Oh yeah, he's right. Makes sense.
A thing that I didn't like, I wasn't a huge fan of Krennic, too much. the bad guy that was working under.
Well, yeah, he didn't.
He just seems Tarkin. So whiny.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're not supposed to like him because he dies.
Well, no, I didn't like him as in he was a good villain or something. Like, I don't like it. I hope you
lose.
You
just thought he was shit. Yeah.
No, I just he didn't do much.
Well, he's kind of how I felt about Voldemort.
Well, he wasn't supposed
worst villain ever.
Well, at least Voldemort wasn't a pawn under anybody. This guy just felt like he was a pawn under Tarkin.
Which he was.
He was.
That's how the Empire works.
But he was supposed to be the main villain.
Also, I like how he wasn't at that point a Grand Moff.
So. Right.
Grand Puppet Tarkin. He looked like something out of a wax museum.
It looked so weird.
He did.
Well, I think that was the better route to take anyway. I hate it when movies recast unnecessarily, especially when we have the technology nowadays to do what they did with him. Yes, it was noticeably CGI, but for kids watching this, they wouldn't have fucking noticed.
Yeah,
they would have been like, oh, wow, that guy looks really old.
It's true.
Yeah. He's gross.
And then they watch episode 4, he's like, wow, that guy looks real.
That guy aged phenomenally.
Right? Imagine watching them in order, and then like, wow, the graphics got really bad, but man, the story is great.
This is awesome.
I know I've heard a lot of stuff saying that since you know he's fake, you'll probably look at it as, oh, like, I'm noticing everything that's wrong with this.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
And so I remember as I watched it, it seemed like at the beginning it was jarring, but the more he was on screen, it became better.
You got used to it.
Yeah, Buddy pointed it out to me in the middle of the thing, and I was like, I mean, I didn't really care. I didn't notice at first because I just thought he was super fucking old.
Right.
And then I was like, oh, yeah, you're kind of right. That is CGI, isn't it?
And then,
oh, well.
And then they got to Leia, and Leia didn't look as bad.
Yeah, she looked pretty
she
good.
Yeah, she looked fine.
I honestly, like, I barely noticed the CGI on her.
Something
honestly,
about her smile
threw
me off. I was like, I don't like that.
I don't like
robot
her smiling
at me. Get away from me, robot.
Get away from me, robot.
You damn dirty synth.
I didn't like what she said either. They completely missed it. I told Tannen when she said hope, she definitely should have said A New Hope and then just looked at the camera and then they roll the credits.
She takes off her mic and just drops it.
I feel like it's better they didn't do that.
Oh, just. No, that would have been so cringy.
I would have never gone to see another Star Wars movie again.
That's a lie.
I'd have been like, nope, can't do it anymore. You fucks ruined it.
The best use of CGI to not bring someone back but to change their appearance to and a previous self would be Michael Douglas from Ant-Man for me.
Yeah, that looked really good. Yeah.
That was amazing.
Fantastic.
Like, not even, you could look at that and not even think, like, CG.
Really. Well,
right.
But they had his face as the...
Well, they would have had Tarkin's face.
Do they? Is he still alive?
Well, no.
He was pretty old in A New Hope.
No, he's not alive. He died in, like, 94.
Yeah.
He's, like, super dead.
Yeah, but
like, as dead as one can be.
Because that was actually Michael Douglas
right.
with like
I think
the
that helped.
Stuff on his face. I feel like that's probably what helped the CGI there, and they couldn't really do that with the dead guy.
Yeah, he died 94.
I nailed it! Mads Mikkelsen.
Who?
That was Jen's father.
Yeah.
Okay, so
he's in a lot. He was the villain from Doctor Strange.
Yeah.
Let's cover him, her
Jinx.
Real quick. Jen.
Yes.
She is the main protagonist. I found her boring. She was probably the one downside to the movie that I would say exists, you know, aside from the bad CGI, quote-unquote. I didn't really, like, care about her. I cared about every other character besides her. She had no stakes in it. She had nothing really going for her. She didn't feel necessary to the story. Like, they even made a point to show how unnecessary she was by pointing out how unnecessary she was. It's like... So the Death Star has a kill me button in it. You do this to do it. Okay, I've told everybody. Now we gotta go. It's like, well, why don't
we
you
gotta
go,
guys? We gotta go.
You're like, you gotta do it. You're the messenger. It's like we all
I
know
think...
the information, though. I can't. Like, my word isn't any better than your word. In fact, they'll hate me more because I'm his daughter.
Right.
That would be horrible for me to tell them that. And then it just shows that it was. The one good scene with her was, like, where she explained why they should go to war and do the whole Rogue One kill me mission.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then
kill me
she
now,
just,
Daddy.
You know, she just failed. It was like, oh, cool.
I lost. I think
she got
she
the information out there.
Yeah, I think she would have been better if they would have portrayed her in the movie more like they portrayed her in the trailers, where it was she was super into the rebellion and she had a bunch of stakes
in
it.
That's what I do, I rebel.
Yeah,
like,
but in the actual movie she wanted nothing to do with them until her dad died.
You're right. I think that would have been
motivation.
Better.
Yeah, but I think
they were trying to differentiate her from
Rey,
yeah. Yeah. Because they don't want their female protagonists all being the same character.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so she was boring for me. Aside from that, I didn't hate her. I just felt her presence was unnecessary.
Yeah, she was fine to me. I don't like her as much as Rey, but, yeah, she was...
Although like, I did find her face less bothering, like, less troublesome.
Bothersome?
Yeah. Like, Rey, her forehead annoys me.
What?
Yeah, I don't know what it is about her forehead.
Her forehead's the hottest part of her.
I would do everything to that forehead.
Get it?
What?
Because she's sick. It's the hottest part of her. Because she's having a fever.
Shut up.
Okay.
That was Raimi level.
I know.
It was like one step below me.
it was like, even worse.
Oh, hey, joke. Like, you're hey, just, joke. You're back
glad
there.
You made it.
Finally caught up.
So proud. Wow.
But Jin, she didn't really have any range of emotion too much.
Mm-hmm. Girl from Twilight.
Kristen Stewart doing a lot more.
Don't compare to Kristen Stewart.
How dare you compare
Felicity
that
Jones
trash.
Is a great actress. I just think she
How
couldn't
dare
really
you
do much
compare
with the
that trash
that
to
well,
Kristen
it's,
Stewart.
It's pretty, I'll give you that. It's better... She is a better actress than Kristen Stewart. Everybody's a better actress than Kristen Stewart.
Remember Felicity Jones's cameo as Black Cat in The Amazing Spider-Man?
No.
2.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I do,
so is that 4 or 2?
Technically, 5.
I did the math wrong, I'm sorry.
I feel like she had the similar issue that Hayden Christensen had as Anakin.
They both didn't like sand.
They both hated the sand. Thing. And also, they're not bad actors. Well, I can't say much for Hayden Christensen.
He's
I don't,
a bad actor.
He's
yeah.
a bad actor.
Yeah,
but,
he is.
But if you watch the behind-the-scenes stuff, you can see how frustrated he is because Lucas didn't really give them much to go off of.
Yeah.
A lot of characters are just completely made up on the fly.
You know who had the worst time filming the prequels? Ewan McGregor.
Yeah, he hated it.
He absolutely hated it.
Well, I heard a thing with Hayden Christensen... If you watch just the parts where he's angry, he plays anger really well.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But when he's trying to romance Padme and stuff,
he's so awkward.
It's so
it's like if Tony were to.
It's coarse and it gets everywhere.
Well, like, he just...
Are you an angel?
Well, I think part of the... fuck that scene. That was the worst scene ever. Like,
we are retreading ground.
Yeah, we're going backwards. Like, he does anger really well, like you said, but he just... I think part of the reason is, again, he had no idea what he was doing. Threw him into something he was not ready for, and then he just kind of freeballed it, and here we are with really god-awful prequels.
Right. Another character everyone loved was K2SO.
Yes.
K2 was the
so
best.
So salty.
Like, he's not my favorite character, but he was the best character by far.
Everything he said was a joke.
Oh, yeah. It was
literally
gold,
everything.
It was perfect.
He was such sass. He was Sassbot 9000.
I loved him so much. Everything he said just made me crack the
That's
hell
what...
up.
That's what...
But it wasn't all a joke, because he had that one line that, like, really stuck with me, because everything he said up until that point was a joke, but then she gave him the pistol, and he goes, "You continue to surprise me, Jyn Erso."
Right,
it was, like,
was
this really
thing.
Sentimental
yeah.
moment between them. It was the one thing he said that wasn't sarcastic, and, like, it stuck with me because of that.
They took out the second part where he says, "With your bullshit."
Fuck you, I hope you die.
Lock the door!
Locks the door.
But yeah, I mean, like, he was the best character. He he had the most range of, like, it was weird. It was, like, it's great that you can see a guy who's voice acting.
Alan Tudyk's a fucking genius.
Play
right.
a character better Definitely. Than the main character.
Yeah.
Like, you get that. He had such a range of emotion.
But to be fair.
From one scene to the next. And he was so sarcastic and just sassy. That's all he was. He did that one thing, and then he had the one scene that really sold a lot of emotion. And it's like,
but,
wow. Fuck everyone else. That guy is the best actor, and he wasn't even on set.
Alan Tudyk. Would you say that that's his niche? I mean, like, because he played exactly pretty much the same.
Being a funny, sarcastic guy in sci-fi
stuff,
yeah, that's kind of his thing.
I was like, is that all he could do, though?
Sometimes he's there, sometimes he's a CGI
I liked him
robot.
I liked him. He was in Tucker and Dale vs. Evil.
Right.
And I liked him there. He wasn't, like, sci-fi or really sassy there.
True.
Like, he was like the Huckleberry Finn kind of...
Yeah,
or,
he was
I'm sorry,
good.
The Thomas...
Sawyer.
Tom Sawyer,
Tom
yeah.
Sawyer.
He was the Tom Sawyer.
Thomas
of that
Sawyer,
movie.
Get inside this minute.
He was a redneck who was Great. Not smart, but not an idiot. So he knew how to manipulate people. But, like, so, you know, in Tucker and Dale vs. Evil, he was, like, just slightly smarter than Tucker.
Mm-hmm.
So it was, like, he was just the dominant friend in that. And that was all he did. So it was a great movie, but it wasn't his niche. So I feel like he can escape from that and do better things. He's got... Most comedic actors actually have a lot of great acting ability. Like, I love seeing Jim Carrey and stuff that's serious. Oh, yeah,
they have to pretend to be happy.
Right. That's what we do. Funny people. That's what we do.
We're funny.
Love me, Dad.
They love to make comedians their robots. Right?
Fuck that guy.
Yeah.
Comedians make great robots.
Like how Bill Hader was a consultant on BB-8.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and who is the guy from Treasure Planet? We were just talking about him the last podcast we did.
Treasure
Planet? Fuck, that was like 3 weeks ago.
Joseph Gordon-Levitt?
No.
Gordon Levitt Joseph?
No.
Levitt Gordon Joseph.
He was in Jungle to Jungle as the friend, the best friend of Tim Allen.
Tim Allen.
The
Martin,
neighbor.
Martin Short.
Martin Short. Thank you.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
I love having Toby.
Oh, speaking of robots.
Yeah, you're Toby now. You were Boney. Now you're Toby.
Moving up in the world. Only one letter off. Here we go.
Anyways,
if I do good again, maybe Boney, I can get the in.
Boney was only one letter off.
So, hold on.
Boney was good.
So speaking of robots, I had one complaint.
Yes.
One complaint with Rogue One. And it's a small inconsistency, and I mean, I know it's probably not exactly a scene you want to see, but you know how they show Yavin 4 where R2 and C-3PO are standing on the fucking ground?
Yep.
Like, oh, dude, everyone's,
they never tell us anything.
Everyone's going on the scarab.
Nobody tells me shit.
Yeah, what the fuck are we going to do? And then it pans up.
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, fucking, you watch episode 4, they're on the fucking ship.
Yep.
It's like, why did they go from A to B?
Where'd they go?
Well, because... No, I can solve this right now. Fucking reshoot the scene where they're being loaded onto the fucking escape ship on the flagship because they are needed.
Well, I mean...
They can say the same exact words.
Rogue One launches, and they go to the base... And then they call for help, and then it shows the scene where everybody's loading onto their frigates and into the X-Wings and everything. I guess you could assume they're doing it, but I agree.
But the scene is after that.
Yeah, when they're shooting that scene, they probably could have had them getting loaded onto a frigate. That might have made more
that
sense.
It would have made the C-3PO line of being like, no one tells me anything, fuck me, I guess.
Right. Which C-3PO and R2 are the only two characters to appear in every film,
yeah. It's great.
Good for them.
Because, well, technically, it's Darth Vader...
His cameo was great. I was so pissed initially because...
I don't think it's cameo, honestly.
Like, his first scene was really, really boring, and I was like...
And then the meme.
He made that awesome pun.
Yeah,
that was great.
Don't choke on your aspirations, bitch.
You know what the worst part is? As soon as you hear it, you knew it was going to be on the internet. That was like, I was right there. I was right fucking there, just sitting there watching that. Oh, God, that's going to be everywhere.
I'm sure they thought about that. They were like, we need to make a meme. Okay, we'll do it.
Let's do it.
We'll do a shitty pun. All right, high five.
That's what
corporate
execs
imagine memes are. Aspirations. And he like just kind of...
It's the pose. Like, it's everything. Like, it's...
Is Darth Vader not in every one of them?
Well, see, that's what I was going to say. Darth Vader, his helmet is in Force Awakens.
He physically couldn't be in a lot of the prequels. Or at least, you know,
most. Well, no, as Anakin.
Well,
Anakin,
that doesn't count.
I guess
it does. Vader. Well, that's the same person.
Vader
killed Anakin!
Thank you!
It doesn't matter.
Vader killed him.
No, that is not how that
that's
works.
That's how Obi-Wan told us.
Was another person born?
Yes.
No.
So Cyborg, a 9-foot asthmatic Frankenstein.
I love Cyborg.
I can't wait to see him in Justice League.
Oh, yeah. Gonna be great.
And also, Episode 6 proves that Darth Vader didn't kill Anakin because he comes back and he's like, I love you, son.
Yeah, he resurrected from the dead.
No.
It's the Force.
Darth Vader
Don't
also resurrected him.
Yes, Darth Vader is
Darth
just
Vader
the
is,
saint.
Yes.
Of the Star Wars universe.
Clearly.
But yeah, have I shown you guys the video of someone recut the scene of Obi-Wan talking to Luke about Anakin? And, like, they recut it to actually fucking feel
it's
like
actually
he's actually
really
talking about, you know, someone he knew.
Yeah. So
the Darth Vader final scene.
Right. But that scene was so hype. Like, oh my God, it made up for him. It was so great. He's sitting there just He's in the goddamn the hallway. He's in there just, like, fucking killing everybody. Right, yeah. Just throwing him against the wall, slamming him up against the ceiling repeatedly. Amazing. Fucking definitely crazy.
It reminded me of...
Impaling them. It was, oh, it was so good.
He was more badass than ever.
Right. Like, that was probably the most badass thing he's ever done ever.
Yeah. As far as making Darth Vader...
Besides killing all those children.
Yeah, you know.
Nah, so that was younglings. Younglings.
Oh, yeah, he's dead.
Yeah, younglings can't put up a fight. They're little bitches. Only Anakin would be that much of a pussy.
If someone killed Anakin when he was young, he would have been all for it.
Oh, I would have loved it if somebody killed Anakin when he was young. Fuck Anakin.
I loved that they brought back people that were in the prequels. Bail Organa, the guy that raised... Leia. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which makes sense, because he's a fucking member of the Alliance.
Yeah. Right. And then Mon Mothma.
Yeah.
The girl that was, like, head of the Rebel base.
Okay, yeah.
She appeared in episode 3, I believe. She didn't have any speaking lines. It was just her taking over, like, a position.
Mm-hmm. Really quickly, yes. Going back to that last Darth Vader scene, it was amazing. Okay. The one thing that upset me was... They were trying to get that door open the whole time, and at no point did he pass it through. He did not pass it through until Darth Vader was killing him.
Yeah, like, why didn't they think that?
They could have kept trying to get it open. There was a bunch of dudes. Yeah, but he could have passed it through at some point, and then they could have kept trying to get it open.
I had the same problem. I'm sitting there, just throw it through. Give it through. Just throw it. Give it to a random guy, and then continue to try to open it, man.
Well, it's not a problem, because they succeeded. They got it through in the end.
Yeah, after fucking 50 tries of, like, her dirt door don't work.
After Darth Vader murdered everybody, and then when he opened the door with the Force, that was amazing at the end, too.
Oh, yeah.
It's so good.
That whole scene reminded me of Force Unleashed.
Yes.
Because it was just so fucking brutal. That game, like, such a... Also, I love the Force Unleashed little nod.
The Darksaber.
The Darksaber, yeah.
Yeah, that no more Darksabers exist.
Like, aww. Starkiller. That's what it was called, right?
Starkiller?
Starkiller base?
No. Starkiller was the... Starkiller. Yeah,
that was the lightsaber, the black one.
Starkiller was the...
He was the pupil Sith. Of Darth Vader.
Yeah, he was Darth Vader's pupil, yes.
Galen Merrick.
That guy.
And James Earl Jones was back for the voice.
Yeah. I honestly felt like he wasn't trying as hard.
I mean, he's old, so I'm sure he didn't have, like, the Luke!
The balls behind it anymore.
Come touch your father!
Was it James Earl Jones?
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I thought he was dead.
What? Even if it wasn't, they could just take his voice and meld it into a sentence.
That's kind of what I thought it was.
Oh, yeah?
Well, it did kind of... I thought
for sure he was dead.
It felt like it wasn't genuine. Yeah. He was, like, he had a higher-pitched voice than what I'm used to.
That's why I thought it was somebody else. Yeah. It wasn't exactly the same. I mean, it was still good.
Yeah, it was spot on.
Don't get me wrong, but it was just a little bit different, and I thought, okay, they recast somebody that was just close enough.
Yeah. Is that James Earl Jones is like Ralph John Morgan? Hi, I'm Ralph John Morgan. I'm going to be voicing Darth Vader.
He looks just like James Earl Jones, except he's white.
Yeah. My favorite part about the movie was that there was no scrolling text for me to read.
Yeah.
You know, that reading was interesting.
Is bullshit. That's iconic. I wanted to walk out of the theater.
I liked it, though, because it set it apart. You knew it wasn't going to be...
That is true. It's not an episode, so...
And also, they had a name for every planet, like, show up on screen, except for Mustafar.
Yeah. Well, everyone knew it was Mustafar.
Right. What about his castle? What about Mordor?
Mordor?
His castle. Yeah.
It looked like something out of a Metalocalypse episode. It was great.
Pretty great.
As soon as I saw that, I was just like, we're just watching Lord of the Rings now. Yeah. This is all this is.
I thought it was funny because it jumped to that right after like the Rogue One team was leaving.
Yeah.
And it immediately jumped to that scene, and they're like, we're going back to the base. And I was like, this looks like a really evil base for a Rogue One base.
We're the good guys, right? Turn.
And then it showed him, and I was like, oh, okay, this makes much more sense. This isn't the Rebel base.
This is going to be scary.
I just like I'm going to be scared. I'm going to be so scared right now. Oh, heroes don't do this.
He's taking a bath in milk to get his calcium up. Bath.
And heroes' tears never die.
He had Imperial Guards.
Yeah, just the like Royal Guard. Aw, they looked great.
Yeah. They would have been killed instantly. Like, no.
Although, there was one scene when they actually did something, and I was so proud of the stormtroopers for actually hitting people. Yeah. Because they were, like, they...
Those weren't stormtroopers.
Oh, yeah, the black ones.
They were death troopers.
Death yes. troopers, yeah.
They're better.
They're they better because they wear black, like, edgelords. But, yeah, they... Like, it was so good, because they actually hit something. I'm just sitting there like, oh, one justified his existence.
You did it.
Good job, buddy.
Good on ya.
So, are the Death Troopers, did they start out as clones?
Death Troopers are like shock troopers. They're like a higher tier. They're
so
like
they were always there?
Like the yeah. special forces.
Yeah, yeah
they're like the SS.
Right.
They were there, but they weren't heavily used, because they were yeah. unnecessary.
There were not a lot of them.
Yeah. Can there be a Star Wars spinoff called Star Wars Death Troopers, where we just follow a squadron of Death Troopers going
it's
around?
It's gonna be real sad, won't lie.
Going around killing everybody, actually hitting my target.
Yeah.
I'm here to kill your friends. Bow wow. Got him.
You'd get like 14 of them, and that's it.
Yeah. Speaking and then of there were the shock troopers that had the jetpacks, and
oh, yeah.
the fucking lightning is great.
Speaking of stormtroopers and death troopers, I thought that the battle scenes in this were probably the best of any Star Wars movie.
Oh,
not
yeah.
just that, not individual fight scenes, but like large scale battles.
The space
just,
battles?
I yeah. really think they
made it seem like
fighting.
There was strategy involved for
yeah.
once. You mm-hmm. know, it wasn't just pew pew lasers.
What should I do with this guy, sir? I'm chasing him. Shoot
fucking
him.
Shoot him.
got
oh, okay. Did it.
And like the fight on. What's the final planet?
Scarif.
The fight on Scarif felt. Really, like, they were just outmatched. They were totally
oh,
outclassed.
They, were,
they
yeah.
were desperate, but they were barely holding on, and then it just, like, inevitably just
oh.
pushed over on top of them.
And then the little hammer ship, they kind of just
oh, God,
pushed the Star Destroyers
that was cool.
Star Destroyers into
yeah.
each other.
That was so cool.
Yeah, that was awesome. It was just like, okay, I've got an idea. What is it? Crash these ships into those. Yeah.
You got it.
You gotta think of what the guy driving that must
have
felt like.
Here
like,
we
was
go.
Just sitting there like, I didn't sign up for this.
Hold on, what? You're
no,
breaking
you
up. You want me to what?
You want me to ram the ship that's 100 times bigger than me?
Do it.
All right, I got you.
I mean, it makes
but
sense.
Like, and just stuff like that. Like, that was just total guerrilla tactics
yeah. I like
of the rebellion.
I like to think that those guys got off. Got out of the ship. I like to think that they survived.
Yeah,
they
I would have got off if
I would have just let
that.
It
yeah,
avoid
same
that.
Here. Just like,
like I would have just
I'm
let
getting
it
off right now,
it.
Sir.
Like, what? Why didn't they think to do that? Like, just have fucking C-3PO do it.
Yeah.
The one useless guy.
But he's not useless.
Oh, he speaks
he's
a lot of language.
He's programmed to understand humans.
Oh.
That's his sole purpose.
His
he speaks
purpose.
Thousands of languages. True.
Yeah, and never uses that tactic.
Nope,
he
never.
Used it one time.
He speaks
in
R2.
Return of the Jedi. Oh, cool.
Yeah.
So did Luke. So did Luke.
Yeah.
Nobody
talks
had
to the Ewoks.
Nobody had a trouble with. Yeah, he used it in Return of the Jedi twice. He used it to translate for Jabba, and then he used it for fucking. He used it for the Ewoks.
No,
well,
he didn't.
Chewbacca.
They would have died if he hadn't used it for the Ewoks.
Well, yeah.
I am their god.
They believe I am their god.
Which is the silliest thing you could
just
ever
just because he's shiny as fuck.
A bunch of fucking teddy bears are worshipping a god, and you're like, this is supposed to be a huge movie? This is Care Bears.
This kind of undermines the fact that there's a giant fucking death ball above us.
As much as I love Return of the Jedi, that part did kind of get to me.
God damn it, why?
Also... Darth Vader never shared screen time with any of the main heroes.
It's true. Because they're all dead by the time
guys. Well, yeah, I mean, what do you expect them to do? Like,
I don't know, he could have killed some of them
yeah,
himself.
Yeah, exactly, he could have.
That's not how
that
it goes.
That was the point. I'd say that was the way I really wanted Donnie Yen to die, was going down against fucking Darth Vader.
No.
That would have been sweet.
Right? He's doing all this kung fu badass shit, and then Vader's like,
but here's
crushes
the thing.
Him into
yeah.
a black orb of nothing.
Yeah.
You believe in the Force?
He's just like laughing. Adorable! And then just, you know, collapses him in on himself. Would have been awesome. I would have paid for that.
Yeah, I really wish he used the whole crumple into a ball thing. That would have been awesome, but also, like, I probably would have thrown up.
It would have been pretty metal.
They, like, slow everything down. They circle the person that's being crushed.
It's like a Mortal Kombat finishing move.
Yeah.
Except slower.
I'm curious as to why Jedis don't do that shit. Or, I guess, Sith Lords. Why Siths don't do that shit more often. Like, I know in the... Because
the Force surrounds you and protects you.
I know in the comics and the books, they did some pretty, you know, metal stuff. But, yeah. Like, for the majority of the time, they're kind of like, meh.
My favorite example of it goes back to Force Awakens, or Force Unleashed, not Awakens. Where, like, there's a point where you can just fucking throw TIE fighters at guys.
Yeah.
Like, this is mine.
There was a moment where he pulled the fucking Star Destroyer down. Yeah. That was pretty awesome.
If you don't have enough midichlorians, you can't just be throwing that stuff around.
You have to buy more. You have to buy more.
I feel like if they did that in the movies, they would make it so everybody would hate when Darth Vader lost, because they'd be like, how can he lose? He can literally crush people into balls of nothingness.
He's Superman, and he lost to Lex Luthor. How the fuck did that happen?
Yeah.
I mean, it happens quite often.
Right.
At the end, Vader never loses.
It's called plot-induced stupidity.
He finds his heart. And then he resurrects Anakin. His tiny robot or heart.
Close enough.
Yeah, I'm tired.
I am tired.
Was this the first live-action Star Wars that they said Kyber Crystal?
I think so, yeah.
Definitely up there.
I was...
it was one of them, yeah.
Caught it. Good.
Yeah, because like it never really explains that part of like how the saber works and right. how the Death Star works, because that's how Death Star works.
Well, how anything giant, works.
It's a giant fucking Kyber crystal in the middle.
Yeah, it's essentially a giant a lightsaber.
Yeah, essentially. Yeah.
Although really in the movie, didn't they justify it as several Kyber crystals, not the one giant one?
Yeah, because it shows all the dropships leaving the Jedi Temple and fucking taking as much as it could.
Are they fusing them all together into one big Kyber crystal? Is that a thing that they can do?
Didn't say.
Probably, yeah. They're just mining a lot of it.
Yeah.
They're just like, oh, we're just fucking smash and grab.
Can we take all of this, please? No.
All.
We're gonna do it.
Okay. Still gonna.
But I'm gonna do it.
We forgot two other people that were from the originals that were also in this. Red Leader and Gold Leader.
Yeah, but they're not the same.
Red Leader, standing by.
And from what I know, they used footage that was unused from the originals and just revamped it and put it in this.
So what was up, what was up with that really long scene of the one X-Wing pilot dying?
The general? Because he was an alliance leader, that's why.
Was he one of... No, not him. Not the one on the planet's surface. It was just some random guy in the Red
Squadron.
Was
it Porkins?
He looked like Porkins.
Was it Red 5?
He was just making a singular, like, bombing run.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And then he just kept screaming that he couldn't get him off him, and then he died.
Oh,
and
yeah,
it was,
yeah.
It was like a five-minute long scene.
They're like, Porkins, what are you doing? He's like, I'm trying to get him off me. Why? They were following all of us.
Yeah.
It can't be Porkins, because Porkins was alive.
That's why I said Porkins 1.
Porkins 2.
The Porkening.
Like, it just it focused on him for a long time, and he's the only pilot that it focused on other than the general, who's actually a character we had seen before.
Right.
It's like that one scene in Saving Private Ryan with the dagger fight. It just goes on for way too long, and you just kind of feel bad.
Mm.
Those of you who haven't seen Saving Private Ryan, there's a scene where the German pins the American down, and the American starts begging for his life as the knife slowly enters his heart.
Oh, nice.
And you get to watch it.
It was pretty nice. It was sweet, really.
It wasn't.
Well,
don't talk about World Wars. Rami's right there. Yeah, you're right. Sorry about
that. Hey, Rami, how's it going?
I'm just going to
Jews don't like to remember.
Memories hurt.
Remember what it didn't happen.
But that...
what it didn't happen.
They might have been Red 5, which is the designation that Luke got when he was flying for them. They called him Red 5.
That
could
have been.
I know they did mention Red 5. I don't know if that was specifically him. But
why are all the pilots obese?
Because they don't have
like
to
none
run.
Of them. None of them are in shape. Even the not morbidly obese guys still have like several layers of fat.
Yeah.
Well, because just like space itself, they're ever expanding.
Shut up!
I don't know. I thought the transport lady was kind of hot. The one in the jump ship that's all like, "We're going down." She dies.
Oh, she was fine.
Well, she was very hot after she exploded.
Yeah, she was
super hot.
You got the joke. Good job.
God damn it, Raimi.
What was up with the general flying an X-Wing? He was super important. He's one of the main leaders of the Rebel Alliance, and he's not only flying an X-Wing, he's one of the only people on the surface.
Well, they didn't realize
he
would get stuck.
Will go into battle with their men.
Yeah, how is a king supposed to lead his pawns if he does not take the first action?
He could have done what the fishman did and just
sit in the works.
Lelouch B. Britannia.
Yes.
Did he?
Yeah, because they show the flagship getting seized.
Admiral Ackbar II, Electric Boogaloo.
Do you honestly think they'd keep an alliance leader alive?
I thought maybe that. I thought maybe their frigate escaped.
No, he gets hit, and they're like, "Hey, the flagship stopped. Let's send a boarding party." That's what.
Oh.
Yeah.
So Darth Vader also does the thing to him.
Probably.
He does a lot of the things.
He does so many
Or he
things.
Probably died in the initial fight.
That could be.
I love the part where they're all trying to jump to get the fuck out. And like two or three get out. And all of a sudden, hey, we're here.
Hi.
And like as they're trying to jump, they smash into the Star Destroyers that are also coming out of light speed.
Whoopsies.
You're like,
that was great.
Shit.
That was the part I really loved. Because like, it really, it's good that they have to calculate that shit beforehand, because they're like, the first scene where they show the jump to light speed, and he's just like, I'm not done calculating yet.
Guess what?
I did it for you, and they hit the button
it's
and shoot
space.
Off. It's like,
we're gonna not hit anything, probably.
Well, yeah, the chances are you probably won't hit anything, but, you know, what if you do?
When you're in like,
what happens if you accidentally hit the one asteroid that's on your path?
Yeah.
Never tell me the odds. Wink.
Wink, wink. I was waiting for that.
I kept waiting for him to say that. He said so many times, do you want to know the odds of this? And
no!
Just one time I wanted him to say, never tell me the odds.
Right. Then they cut him off on the, I have a bad feeling about this.
Yeah.
I have a bad feeling. Shut the fuck up. We know.
we get it. it's such a good movie. Like, I was really happy about
it. Yeah, legitimately pleased.
I thought... They did good.
They did damn do good.
I understand that people would love this movie, think it's amazing, whatever. But I still think
we're gonna have the Jew come out.
I still think that I like Force Awakens
more.
Nope,
you're wrong and you should feel bad for having that opinion.
What was better about that?
I don't know, it feels more nowadays how movies are. This did feel like it fit with the original trilogy perfectly.
Yeah. Which is the best part about Star Wars.
Yeah, which is the best part about it, is that it's going back to when movies were good and took risks.
Well, I said this in the Star Wars podcast, too. I wasn't as young when I watched the originals, and so that's probably why.
You don't have any nostalgia goggles.
So, Googles. Yeah, I personally like Force Awakens more, but this was still awesome. And it fit with the original trilogy amazingly.
I like this one more than... The Force Awakens, because I think it took more risks. It did more risky things than The Force Awakens, which I think played it really safe.
Yeah. Things
Force
that Awakens were very risky.
It played it really safe.
Played
they
the game a risk.
They didn't do a lot of just crazy out there things like killing their entire starring cast or things like that. They only had one prominent death. And other than that,
everybody knew it was coming.
Yeah, everybody knew it was coming. There's a huge lead up. Nobody else died. Nobody else even came close to death. There was almost no stakes, but in this one there were stakes, and they lost. And like
that's why it's a one-off. That's why it's not numbered or anything, because like everyone's gonna.
No,
die.
There's a number.
Yeah, one.
It's one.
Yeah.
It's one.
I
saw a Kotaku article saying that the headline was, "Will
that
we see a Rogue 2?"
I'm
like, what?
That'd be amazing.
Excuse me, how?
They bring all the characters back from the dead.
It's actually them all in purgatory, reliving their life as if they didn't leave that island.
Oh.
Wait, shit, wrong show.
Other than the Rebel Alliance, was there anybody left alive at the end of the movie that could have even starred in Rogue 2?
No.
No one is alive. Everyone is
Mon
dead.
Moth.
Yeah, Mon Moth, she's still trucking.
They can have a movie
still
just
sitting
about
patiently
her.
At a table.
She, Rogue 2.
What she does just throughout the entire original trilogy.
Leading the... Alliance.
I like to imagine she's like Thanos. She just doesn't leave that table. Like, he doesn't leave his chair. Why don't you move? No.
See, that's another thing that I really liked about it. It felt like a Marvel movie. I know that Disney owns both of those, but it really, like, the way they kind of Joss Whedoned it to where they went from a serious moment to a funny moment.
Oh, sure, in that way, yeah. Well, Star Wars did that too. It always had
small
jokes, but
the
small
jokes.
So...
Yeah, I really liked that about the whole series. But like, I felt like this one did it the best out of all of them, and mostly because of K2.
He was the only one. I honestly couldn't tell you another joke that happened in that movie that wasn't him.
My favorite scene with him was when he caught the grenade, and then he's like in mid rant and just kind of like chucks it behind him and kills a bunch of people.
Because he's a what was he, a fucking analytics bot? He was, like, strategic something.
Right, yeah, yeah.
So, like, he calculated everything,
For the Empire, repurposed.
Mm. I also like how they made him do the most fucked up thing ever by making him kill another version of him.
Yeah, that was dope. He was so sad about it, too.
Like, you know what he had to do?
Aww. I don't wanna though. Do it.
I like always taking. The I have Chirrut to take that. And Baze kind of buddy cop thing they had going on.
Like, that they was were
just Chirrut and
Baze.
Baze,
isn't that his name? Baze, the guy with the Mexican. Gun.
Oh
the
yes.
Fucking awesome, fucking chain gun from the Clone Wars.
That like they kind of had a cool thing going on when he was like, "Good luck," and he's like, "I don't need luck. I have you."
Yeah, that was kind of
Baze
nice.
Just follows him.
Fuck!
It's like, damn it, he does have me. Shit.
I mean, like, he's not wrong.
It was very Guardians-esque.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's what I've been getting a lot of. People have been saying that it reminds them of Guardians of the Galaxy, and that's a good thing.
Guardians did have less characters, though, which I think helps it in that everyone's different, while this...
And everyone had jokes, really.
I agree that some of the side characters were more enjoyable than Jin.
Yeah.
But there is definitely a rank I think you could put to them.
Yeah.
I would say robot, blind guy, Mexican guy, more Mexican guy.
You guys have to try to figure out which one's more Mexican.
And then
leave a comment if you
the
know.
The actual Spanish man or then, the one that looks kind of
Is
the guy who
played Empire pilot guy. Then
I don't think so.
Girl.
He's Chinese.
Yeah.
Baze is Chinese.
Really?
Yeah, he's played by Wen Jiang.
Really?
He was born in China in 1963.
Huh, cool.
Then, yeah, Cassian was the other guy.
Okay, blind Chinese guy then. Then big Chinese guy. Then Mexican guy.
What did you think of General Draven's plan?
What plan?
He just wanted to kill Galen. Urso, the whole time.
Yes, yeah, yeah. That
Why?
Was...
I didn't understand that. He was like, he's building a weapon, and then they transmitted it to him. Like, the weapon's already built. And he's like, all right, you have to kill him now.
Yeah, you have to kill
he's
him.
He's already built the weapon. Why does he have to die? The better thing to do would have been to bring him in. Even if you thought he was against you, would be to bring him in and, like, interrogate him about it.
Bring out that little black robot you never see do anything in New Hope.
Yeah.
Nope,
there
just
was
kill him.
No reason at all to kill him.
I think it's because
he's just a dick. I think they were just trying to highlight his dickishness.
Yeah, he was a huge cock.
Like the biggest of cocks.
Cock alpha. Cock
alpha. I would go so far as to call him a cock and balls.
Hmm.
He's alpha and omega, the beginning and the end. The cock and balls.
The cockening.
Okay, we have episode 8 gonna be coming out soon.
Right.
Next year.
Yeah. Is it one a year for the next few years?
Pretty much.
Well, see, I don't
They're
know.
They're gonna be shooting for that
beyond episode 8. Well, there's a Han Solo.
There's 8, then there's Han Solo.
The Han Solo.
Solo.
Yeah.
Emilia Clarke is gonna be in the new Han Solo movie.
Who's that?
Emilia Clarke.
I mean, who is that?
She's the one that plays Khaleesi in Game of Thrones.
Bae.
Did you see?
She's super blonde and has dragons.
Oh,
did you see
I know.
Her? Did you see Me Before You?
No.
You should probably see it. It's
I'll
really
see
good.
You before anything.
Have you seen The Notebook? That's just like a side question.
That's a. It's a really good movie, but she's the main character in that too.
What did you guys think about? They made it canon that the engineer of the Death Star put in the failsafe.
Yeah,
I loved it.
Yeah, it's fun. It's salty as fuck, and it's great. It makes so much sense because it's like he realized, you know, it may be a couple years, but they're still gonna fucking do it.
Well, it's an exhaust port. Don't things need exhaust ports anyway?
Yeah.
It's not like...
Well, it's space.
I put in this thing.
Well, no, you don't want buildup of gases in your fucking reactor.
Right. But it's space. Where's it going?
But I just like it that... I like it because it diffuses all of the people who had that complaint saying, why would they make this huge fatal flaw in the Death Star? Like, they didn't.
Because it was on purpose.
They didn't know it was on purpose.
Well, did you watch the Robot Chicken thing?
Yes.
It's hilarious. It was a 3x3 meter thing on a moon-sized fucking space station. What, like, even if that was, like, the one design flaw and it wasn't, like, you know, the dude's master plan or whatever.
Put a grade over it.
It's still fucking, like, the chances of it are so slim that you needed a goddamn Jedi with fucking telekinesis to guide a fucking guided missile.
It was a 90-degree turn.
Yeah. Like, they tried it once, and it just missed
entirely.
I love
the sound they play while it goes into the tube, too. Doom,
doom.
Doom.
I wish I got food. I'm hungry.
Do you want to get food afterwards?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you want?
I'm kind of craving Taco Bell, if I'm going to be real.
I know you do. That's fine, but like...
Where do you want to go?
You gross Mormons.
What?
Yeah, he's Mormon now.
Oh, congrats.
I hate Mormons.
Yeah,
yeah,
exactly.
It's the bane of his existence, actually.
Why?
Don't worry about it. It's a long story.
Yeah, it's a really long story.
Okay, now it's going.
Just know it's general hatred.
We can't, like, summarize it?
No.
Long story short, every woman I've ever loved has been in love with a Mormon before me, so I just have a really bad taste in my mouth for Mormons. Plus, have you ever met, like, a hardcore Mormon?
Only a few times.
It's really fucking annoying.
Like, we went to high school with one. He was a great guy. Salt of the earth.
No, he was not. He was a fucking dickweed. Every time I drank a Mountain Dew in front of this guy, and this is probably just because I was banging the girl that he had a crush on, but like, every time I drink a Mountain Dew, he'd be like, yeah, that's poison that you're putting into your body.
Cool,
sure, that's great. I'm a high schooler and I need to stay awake, so I'm gonna drink
you
this
Mountain
Dew.
You just see the other shit my friend here puts in his body.
Yeah.
I think he's
Turn really... does heroin!
He just really
and you're
surprised.
Looking mad at me for doing Mountain Dew?
Come on!
What doing Mountain Dew.
Doing the Dew as they will.
Doing the Dew.
As the kids do.
Nice.
So that was the best story I've ever heard in my life.
Oh no, they get better with us. We have some doozies.
How many girlfriends was it?
Two.
It's two now.
That is still
it's a good track record. It's better than my Mormon record.
Both of them have technically rejected me for the Mormons, and then later on figured out that the Mormons are pieces of shit, and then started dating me. But
rejected
like,
you for the Mormons.
It just made me hate the Mormons even more.
The Mormons.
So maybe Mormon people
are
great, but
and they get them everything.
The two Mormons that I've met, just awful people. So. That's all I have. 100% of the Mormons.
To be fair,
met,
their
so.
Entire religion is bullshit anyway.
Yeah, that's fair.
If you're Mormon,
if you die and become God, you're not a religion anymore.
If you're a Mormon, please comment on how cool you are.
I just
want to
throw this out here. My name's Tannen, and I'm not a racist.
He's a fucking liar.
Nah, not on this kind.
Not online.
Mormon's not a race, you asshole.
Shut up, they don't know that.
I guess you could say white, but...
Right, exactly. Actually, no, I do hate white people. Fuck
I met a black Mormon once. All right.
Sweet.
He was weird as fuck.
Good story.
Hey, going back to Star Wars.
Yeah, because that's getting...
So Mormons,
Were there any Mormons in Star Wars?
No. Yeah, were there?
No.
No.
I mean, maybe.
Maybe. We don't know
they
if there's space Mormons.
Is there any other religion besides the Force?
I'm sure.
Star Wars?
Probably. I don't think any are...
Yeah.
There's got to at least be one other religion.
Someone that believes in...
Would you count the Sith?
No, they still believe in the Force.
Yeah, that still is the Force. You're a bunch of godless heathens, space people.
I'm on Wikipedia right now. I'm trying to figure it out.
Wikipedia. That is still the greatest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah, that's the name.
Next to Mormons being awful people. that still takes the cake.
I don't know. There are others, but they're all kind of like, what do
you
say?
Don't give you superpowers.
Oh. Right, exactly. They just, like, give you rules you have to follow and shit.
I don't hate Mormons. I just hate the few that I've met, and I don't...
Why are you still... It's getting cut.
You know what?
No, it's not.
Bring it back.
We're bringing it back.
Let's get our first shirt.
I don't hate them, but, like, I just don't agree with their beliefs, and I don't like the few that I've met, so...
But, like,
so,
maybe
you know,
Hitler was
so
kind of right.
Jesus. Probably close enough. No, not, Jesus wasn't a Mormon.
It's true.
What about
he's a Roman?
What about Jesus?
You should
son?
Know. You should know all about Jesus, Raimi.
No,
you,
I don't know about
you. Killed him.
You did kill him, Raimi.
I'm not Christian. I don't know about Jesus. I don't worry about him.
He's just some
dude. You murdered him.
I did not murder him. I know a select few Jews that have murdered him, and I don't like them.
I don't like them because they aren't my friends. Not like those other cool Jews I know. To continue on our force sensitive conversation.
No.
Okay.
No.
Donnie Yen's character. He is
I don't
the epitome
do
of
this
that.
Anymore.
If you need to know what a force sensitive is versus what a force user is, that's it. Look
they
at
fucking,
him.
Just to let you know, they argued about this for a good fucking hour.
It was not an hour.
Yes,
it
was.
if he'd watched, he'd know.
There's a point where I look at the microphone and I'm like, I'm so sorry, guys.
Okay, I have one question. What's the difference between
a black guy having and a white guy?
The force on your side versus just being fucking lucky? In any other movie, if a guy walked through a war zone, which has happened in movies, you wouldn't say that guy's using the force because the force doesn't fucking exist in that universe. He's just
for
lucky.
For all intents and purposes, he could have just gotten lucky
right.
out of that.
That's
no
what
one knows. But I mean, the fact that he's fucking prayer chanting the entire time kind of.
It's all left up to belief.
Kind of skews it, yeah.
Right. Well, that's just, what it is. It's belief.
And
so.
That's another reason why I love this is because they brought it back to the belief system rather than I've got some pretty good midichlorians up in my butt. Like yeah.
I injected a shit ton this morning.
He believed in the force, and just because everybody else didn't believe in it, he still did. And because of that, he was in his head. He was able to get through that sort of shit.
Yeah.
It helped him out.
It still may have not given him any force powers, though, is what I'm saying.
Right.
He
may
just
not
been lucky.
That may be the case.
Why
but,
doesn't he get a lightsaber?
Because there aren't any left.
Because he's not a Jedi.
No one knows how to make them.
Kyber crystals don't exist anymore.
He's sitting on a temple of Kyber crystals.
Right.
Well, yeah,
on Kyber crystals.
He was just...
They all use blue
eyes. He was just a guardian, though. That's all he was allowed to do was guard it.
I guess
and because
true.
He believed in the religion, he wasn't a Jedi.
Plus, I mean, at this point... How many people knew how to make a lightsaber?
It's true. He had no master to teach him. He had no way of figuring it out.
He didn't go on some journey to find his crystal.
Plus, don't they, like, make you do it with your telekinesis?
Yeah, you have to assemble it like that with the force.
Yeah, you have to
do like,
it
Because, like, if you fuck it
force.
Up, it explodes, and it's probably not good.
Yeah.
Well, like, no, that's the final part of your Jedi training, is you're gonna have to go to wherever the... Not Jeddah, because I know it's not Jeddah. That's where they just stored Kyber crystals.
Bumfuck nowhere.
No, there's some. It's an actual planet. I don't remember.
I thought
Jeddah
was like their main temple.
It is. It's the one
Fun
in
fact,
Knights of the Old Republic.
It was the main Jedi temple in Knights of the Old Republic.
I just said that.
I wasn't listening to him.
Hey, I have a fun fact for you guys.
Thank you for letting me know that, Brandon.
You're welcome.
Jeddah was the main something-something I wasn't paying attention of the
something,
Jedi's.
Something.
Brandon already said that.
Anyways, Brandon's the only useful friend.
There's a planet. I'm looking up right now. But anyways, you go there, you find your crystal, you come back.
Okay.
You just land on the surface. You're like
well, no,
a lazy Jedi, and you're like, okay, here's
they're
a rock.
They're in caves, you have to fight stuff.
This is a lightsaber.
Hopefully this one works.
And the colors are a nice thing that I like about that with the Kyber crystals. They represent a specific type of Jedi that you are.
Yeah.
That's why all the Sith have red. That's why the blue represents speed, and green is a guardian.
Barry Allen?
I kind of feel
best of my life.
The greens are guardians. The yellow is the like that's the high class fighter fuckers that will you know mess you up. Purple is Samuel L. Jackson.
Rainbow.
Rainbow doesn't exist.
There's what?
White.
That's white. White and black.
I like it.
And white, you
orange?
Have to like you upgrade to that somehow. You have to.
Pink?
It's like the force goes through. Orange is.
You're not answering my question.
Well, you're just kind of throwing it in the middle of a sentence.
What is orange?
Orange.
They're like the special forces.
Yeah.
Their sole purpose is to hunt down and kill Sith.
Yeah, they're specifically just there to kill the Sith.
Isn't there one that it's like. You're on your own. Like, you're not a Jedi,
white.
But you're also not a Sith.
White.
Is that white?
Gray Jedis.
Yeah,
yeah gray Jedis are like that. And to get a white saber, it's a transcendence moment. It's not, like, you can't just make that out of a Kyber crystal that's white. You have to, throw all the Kyber crystals in one thing and see what happens. You have to physically...
You have to actually combine five people, and they all form together to summon your white crystal from the earth. I was going Captain Planet,
so
but I couldn't...
What about...
Are the Kyber crystals colored, or do you get assigned a color?
You get assigned a color.
What about chartreuse?
Shut up.
Brown?
Blue lightsaber
where's
is
the,
probably the most standard color.
Where's the brown Jedi's?
Associated with protection, consciousness, and intellect. Probably force uses.
They changed it since the last time I read that shit.
Well, I'm probably also on a different fucking website than you, so fuck you.
It's like a blog.
Moviepilot.com.
Well, I got my information from an old game that they had.
Yeah, I was trying to find that because I also read that, but... Green is used by Jedi counselors who prefer negotiation and meditation, but have strong force abilities. Red, obviously, is fucking evil.
That's wrong.
Also, synthetic crystals, not actual real Kyber crystals. Blue... warriors, you know, you fight. Purple is a Jedi who uses both light and dark side techniques with an aggressive style. So it's a mixture between...
Because he's on the...
Which light. Is hilarious.
Because he's a bad motherfucker.
He's on the light side, but he's dark.
Which is hilarious, because you'd think Luke would have that.
Like a turkey.
Nice.
Yellow is Sentinels who seek to destroy Darkseid and Sith. You know.
The Sentinels from X-Men, Days of Future Past.
The orange is stealth combat, pretty much. They're just assassins. Okay. Other yellow.
Orange
other,
isn't really
other orange.
Stealth color.
Shut up.
I don't think any color. It's a glowing. It's a big glowing it's a night tube light. Of light.
What does the black saber
wait, what
look
is the
like?
Gray
the black saber is black.
Used by those.
That'd probably be nice.
It would be. You would think. But
you're
it's,
an assassin.
Right. I would say
black
so.
Black is controlled by self-obsession. Also known as dark saber.
Dark sabers are extremely rare, though. That's the issue of it. There's only, like, so many in existence, and only...
So are Jedis.
Jedis are less rare than that.
But so the dark saber would only be able to be used by Sith.
Theoretically, but... I mean, like, you could technically be self-obsessed if you were a monk. You'd just
you could
to...
just be an asshole.
Yeah.
I guess that's true.
I mean, Father Donovan was an asshole.
There's so many things that lead to the dark side.
Right?
It's hard to keep track.
Everything.
My favorite.
Literally anything you do leads to the dark side.
Well, that's why...
Sodomy.
That's why I wish they would have a movie. What I want them to do is, I want them to have the movie conjoining The Empire Strikes Back and The Return of the Jedi. Most people, like the casual Star Wars watcher or the moviegoer, they didn't read the books. They don't know all the story
he
behind it.
He goes fucking
it.
Evil.
Return of the Jedi, yeah, he goes evil before then. The reason it's the return is because beforehand he was a Sith. He went dark side for a little while so he could fully understand the Force.
Yeah.
You said the word conjoining.
Yes.
And I was thinking about
twins.
Luke and Leia being conjoined twins.
They weren't, though.
I'm different.
I'm different would have been, yeah. Okay. So, final thoughts, guys. So, final thoughts.
Oh, no. Before we get to final thoughts, what other thing would you want them to make a one-off movie about that they haven't already announced yet in the Star Wars universe?
If I had to pick one, I would say the in-between the Return of the Jedi and Empire Strikes Back, just to help explain the dark side Luke thing, the whole actual returning of a Jedi thing. But if I couldn't pick that, because that would kind of technically be... Not much of a one-off, because it'd be Luke.
It'd be like a short film.
I would...
A mini-series on Netflix.
I would say...
that's even longer than a movie.
I would say something involving the Mandalorians.
That'd be pretty cool, yeah.
What
well, I mean, we're going to get
the Mandalorians are like... The Mandalorians are a race of people who... It's Boba Fett and his gang.
Oh,
like,
got
it's,
it.
He's not
we're
a Mandalorian,
gonna get it, though.
But he's wearing Mandalorian armor. They're the people who... Look.
Wait, they canceled the Boba Fett film?
I think they canceled the Boba Fett solo movie.
No
way. That was the one I was most looking forward to.
Well, it's because they knew.
Well, if there's a spinoff, I'd want it to be one of Boba Fett.
Okay. There you go. Okay, no. For you, if it wasn't Boba Fett?
I kind of would like to see some more origins, like Darth Maul. I'd like to see a standalone Darth
that'd
Maul
be cool.
film.
Oh,
I think that'd be awesome.
Will he have his spider legs?
Just him doing, like...
That'd be
Darth
great.
Maul
that's
things,
a Rebels joke.
Going in, yes. assassinating people.
Well,
just
that's a
like,
Clone Wars show.
Right.
He's the protagonist, but it's just him being evil. I think that'd be
the same
really
way
awesome.
That they wanted to do, or like Suicide Squad or something.
Yeah,
just
yeah.
Because
they were gonna make a game about it at one point, and it sounded amazing. And I think it would be just, I think it'd work just as well as a movie because he's such a cool character. If they don't do it in 8 and 9, I'd like to see how the Knights of Ren. Were formed.
I'm sure they'll get it.
I'm sure they will, but if they don't like do an in-depth backstory, I think that would be cool.
There's a lot that they set up in 7 that they will have to pay off at some point, or else people are gonna hate it.
Yeah, definitely.
Ken?
Credits.
We're not there yet. We're not there. We're close.
As a movie?
We're almost there.
No.
Just credits.
Credits the movie.
No, I would like to see. I hate to say it, but I like to see it go back to the prequels. Not follow the shitty drama that was the prequels, mind you. But I like to see, like, a day in the life of a Sith hunter. Like, follow one of him around. Like, fucking shit up and be like, alright, I need to find this guy. He's gotta die.
If it goes back to that, what I would want it to do is actually explain these little adventures that fucking Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin went on.
No.
It's like they had such this back and forth for a little bit there, and you're just sitting there like, man, these great adventures, when they're actually like doing stuff, makes it
probably
seem so
great.
Or
even better, I'd like to see it follow a squadron in the Clone Wars.
That'd be cool.
That would be.
Did you ever play Clone Commando?
No, I didn't play Clone Commando.
That
but
was probably the last FPS game that wasn't like Overwatch that I really enjoyed.
I played Battlefront 2, and that had like a story that explained like the campaign that they had, like how they seized the galaxy, pretty much.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, I'd like to see like fucking one of those special forces group, you know, go in and fuck some droids up. Mindless, cool. Gratuitous violence and wartime themes.
Or maybe like a Darth Sidious.
Ooh,
origin story.
I'd yeah. like
well,
them.
His origin was...
I would like them to go beyond the prequels.
The
back to Knights of the Old Republic. That'd be
oh,
cool.
That, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, Darth Nihilus. I would love to cover Darth Nihilus. He was a fucking awesome, badass motherfucker.
So they should just keep making Star Wars movies forever?
So,
yes.
They will. They
which
will.
Side would you rather form? Empire or Alliance?
Do I have the Force?
No. You're just
okay.
You.
Oh, fuck. I'm gonna go Empire, but not high enough Empire that I'd be talking to Darth Vader. Just
yeah. I don't want to be the guy in the background like, oh, fuck.
Pretending to do things, right?
Jesus,
you're the guy in the
dead.
Background watching Darth Vader choke people like, glad I don't have to deal with him.
I'm just doing my work.
If I fuck up, I'm just gonna get yelled at for a little bit.
I go home to my wife, and I'm like, I saw Darth Vader today. She's like, oh my god, are
How
you okay? Are you emotionally scarred forever?
He killed 3 guys!
Right?
Again,
but
on a bright side, I have a better parking spot now.
You go home and you're like, he killed 3 people. I got promoted again. I'm getting closer.
I don't want
to. She's like, honey, you have to quit.
Meredith, we
I
need to run.
Quitting. It's the Empire. Where am I gonna quit to?
Alliance? Fuck that.
Again?
This is bad.
I won't live there.
I'm dead no matter what.
Every
did
time
you go to Hoth?
Every time you get a promotion, you and your wife don't celebrate, you just cry. That's a day of sadness.
Jim got promoted instead of me. Party time.
Woo! Sorry about it, Jim. They're like in Jim's house.
Oh, but yeah, congrats, Jim.
Congrats, buddy.
I mean, there's no pay because we're all just on this fucking death ball.
Death ball where, you know, you just die.
Yeah, I mean, you're just... I
you get choked to death at some point.
Who wants to join in on the Deadpool with me? Do you think Jim's going to die tomorrow or the next
What's
day?
Jim's ranking right now? Oh, he's second lieutenant.
He's getting close.
I'm putting money down on Jerry.
He's going to have to give...
Jerry's a colonel now.
He's going to have to give Darth Vader an update as to how the Death Star's doing.
You're the guy underneath Jim, and you just put $100,000 on Jim's death and spend the entire day fucking shit up.
Yo, Vader. Hey, yo, Vader. Jim? Fucking didn't change the coffee filter out. Just thought you'd want to know.
But yeah, then you'd be like the guy who goes right up next to him. You're the next one in line at that point.
Right, so then you make
true.
Everyone else
that's one
bad.
Fucking gamble.
Didn't You're... Darth Vader also force choke somebody that was on another ship?
Yeah, yeah, well, he's
point,
like
yes.
in the middle of a FaceTime
yes.
meeting.
Yes. yes. And so he doesn't even have to go to Jim. He just like thinks
fucking
about
Jim.
Him. Yeah. Jim died. Darth Vader wasn't even near him.
He just fell dead.
Honey, what do we do?
Jim,
I don't know.
He was driving the car home, so it's kind of weird.
Jim choked to death today. We gave him the Heimlich for 20 minutes before we realized it was Darth Vader.
It was really fucked up, too, because like Vader knew he was eating.
It was during his lunch break.
We broke poor Jim's ribs before he died, and we it didn't
he
even matter.
He screamed in pain. It was more of a...
Our advanced,
he was gasping so hard.
Our advanced mechanics and fucking doctoring has showed us that he suffered horribly before he died.
Just like all of them.
I think
oh,
that should
man.
Be its own spin-off.
Oh,
just
yeah,
a day in the life of
Vader
the poor people working
people.
On the Death Star.
Yeah,
was
about to say,
murdered by Vader.
Tannen always would say how in Harry Potter he wants to follow just a random like Hufflepuff.
No, not Hufflepuff. I just want to follow a group of friends that went to Hogwarts same year as Harry.
Yeah, yeah.
They're just like they're
just what they're doing.
Like
they don't
us.
Really see him too much.
That could be like cool with like the Jedi Temple, like
yeah.
when they're training younglings.
Yes.
Just
yeah.
like a day in the life of
the teachers.
Not the little kids,
no,
but
yeah.
like
but
a community.
Like, yeah.
The movie like, ends with Anakin walking in.
Like when they're like mid range, like right before they go on their quest for their Kyber crystal. Like that could be
right.
kind of cool.
It ends with them like walking out of the temple to go home. Like, man, city's really dark all of a sudden.
Oh, wow. It'd be amazing. They're like, look, it's Master Skywalker, and then credits.
Yo, what's up, man?
He's coming to save us all.
Oh, what? We got another fight to go. Like credit roll at the very end. You just.
It just leads you off with the word younglings.
The end credit scene is just the exact scene from the third one
yeah.
where he. pops his lightsaber right in front of the kids.
Yes.
People wait through the credits to see that one more time.
The credits, the kid backs up and startlement, like, whoa. Are you going to teach us some awesome saber tricks?
Or the after credits scene is...
Sir, there's no need for sparring right
it's,
now.
It's the deleted scene of when he actually just kills them. No cut.
He's fucking up the entire time. He misses, like, whoops. He falls over.
They're dodging back and forth. They're like, come on, Anakin.
I like to think that he just accidentally killed them all. Like, yeah. He was like... I can't do it, and then, like, Jimmy just walks right in front of it.
Just walks through you
and cuts him in half. They all start panicking, and it just turns into shit. He's like, no, quit it! It, like, turns around, kills Becky.
No! No, like, a couple of them try to, like, flee from the room because they're all frightened and fall down the stairs and die. That'd be great.
He killed younglings.
but, like, on accident.
And then, like, I mean, on like, the security it footage, it's just, like... Him like panicking
he's
and then
looking at
one...
the camera, he's like, it's not me.
You know what? Clone is just like, delete.
You know what? The one thing that would have helped those younglings, and the one thing I'll always preach to always have with you,
a lightsaber, a
pocket sand,
pocket sand,
especially against Anakin.
He's like, I hate sand,
get it away.
It's bad night. It's his kryptonite.
Sand,
ah, not again.
All right, so. Final thoughts about Rogue One.
Pretty good.
I'd give it an A. It did a good job.
I'd give it an A+.
I'd give it a solid 9 out of 10.
I'd give it a D.
It
my penis.
Felt so much like the originals with
it felt so good.
Amazing CG.
Yeah. Everything was so pretty. The script was well written. All the actors were great. Almost nothing wrong with it. Like, to really go to say things are wrong with it is just nitpicky.
Right, yeah, exactly. Right.
Like, that's the only thing you can find wrong with it is small nitpicks.
I love the dynamic range of the sets. Like, the closest thing was Yavin 4 to Scarif. And, like, even that's a stretch.
Mm-hmm. And it was a war movie.
Yeah.
Legitimate brutal. War.
Brutal.
Yeah, very brutal. Don't take your kids.
Take your kids.
Make your kids go by themselves.
Yeah. Don't explain anything to them. Just be like, that's life.
That's life. That's life, Steven. Have fun.
Yeah, how unfortunate some of those people... Because there's like a scene where one of the trooper transports goes fucking down on the beach and just you see stormtroopers get fucking mowed down by it. You're like, oh shit.
Didn't make it.
Oh, all right. Jesus.
Is Django okay? He got hit by a Star Cruiser.
So on is fire. Chris going to be okay?
Yeah, but this is the future.
No!
Yeah, but is he okay, though? No.
He might be, but after that he got blown up by the Death Star, so I guarantee he's dead.
Pretty sure.
Look at all the shit that Anakin was put through. He had all of his limbs chopped off, and then he
set on fire.
To be fair, though, it did carterize the wound as it happened.
Doesn't mean it doesn't fucking hurt.
I'm sure it did. He got cut in half by a laser. His life sucks.
Obi-Wan had the high ground. He warned him.
He warned him. I have the high ground.
Yeah.
He's like, so what? I can do an awesome strategy. Flip to you.
Can they change that line to, if you jump up here, Anakin, I'll cut you in half.
Gonna slice you into bits.
I will cut you in half. I swear to fucking God, Anakin, I will cut you in half.
That was the podcast. I was Raimi.
Tannen.
I was Brandon.
Tony.
He was Tony.
Marlon Brando.
He was also Boney.
He was also Boney and Toby.
Boney
in case you rewatch it.
And Shobi.
And Kenobi.
I added that one. Yeah, Ben Kenobi. So once again, this has been the Drawn Out Podcast. Have fun.
Yeah, thanks for listening.
Love you.